Hello everyone, welcome to Math at Home. Today we're going to be building terrariums out of recycled material.
This is a terrarium. It's a mini garden in a clear jar.
The goal of building a terrarium is to make a self-sustaining ecosystem within your jar. You might never have to open your terrarium again once you've built it. It works because plants release water during photosynthesis in a process called transpiration. The water they release condenses on the top of the jar and then trickles down. It's really cool because this is actually just like the water cycle on Earth.
Transpiration mimics evaporation, which water then condenses on the sides of the glass and then precipitates back down through dripping where it collects in the soil. The plant basically creates its own water cycle, just like the water cycle on Earth that recycles all of the water for plants and animals to use again.
To build our terrariums, we're only going to need a few materials. The first thing we're going to need is a clear jar. You can probably find one of these at home and just clean it out and reuse it. A peanut butter jar, a jar from pasta sauce, a pickle jar, which is what I'm going to use, or even a jam jar is going to work. Really, any big jar that can fit a plant that you can find around house and clean out is going to be perfect. Next, we're going to need some rocks. These are my rocks right here. Really, any rocks are gonna work. You want them to be pretty small, like gravel, terrarium rocks, or aquarium rocks that you can find at the store are gonna work. These are gonna add drainage to our terrarium. Next, we're gonna need soil. Any plain old potting, gardening soil will work for this.
As you can see, I'm getting mine a little drink of water because it's very dry, and I'm gonna mix it up really well. And then it's ready to be used in our terrarium.
We're also going to need a small terrarium plant, and this is where the fun comes in. So you can use any small terrarium plant you can find at the store. The main requirements are that it is small and slow growing, it loves humidity, and it can tolerate mid to low light conditions. So there's lots of plants at the store that you can find that will work for this. Some plants that I would recommend are a nerve plant, an African violet, any species of moss, and many different kinds of ferns as well. Lots of gardening stores actually have a terrarium plant section. There's also a lot of plants that we can find right outside that'll be great for our terrariums.
Let's head outside and look for some plants. So this is what lichen usually looks like. You can find it usually on the sides of trees growing on the trunks. What's really cool is lichen is not really a plant. It's actually a life form created from a mutual relationship between algae and fungi.
A lot of people think that lichen is a disease on their trees and want to remove it, but it actually is not at all. It means the tree is healthy.
Another plant really commonly found outside is moss, just like this one and this one. You can find it a lot near really moist areas on stones and fallen logs. As you can see here, it's really easy to just pick it up and you can take a little piece and put it right into your terrarium.
If you already have some houseplants, there are some great houseplants that can be propagated that will also thrive in your terrarium. Propagation is just when you use a mother plant to create more smaller plants. So this can be done with seeds, but a really common way with houseplants is actually cuttings. And then you can place it in soil and it'll root. African violets, pothos species, Trandoscantia, and many others. I have some more links on propagation in the description below if you want to check those out. Another thing that I love to place in my terrariums are tiny decorations. So I have a few here that we can use, but you can also find some around your house or outside or make some of your own. Finally, we're gonna need some water. Now this is really important because all plants need water to survive, but the great news is if you water it once, you might never have to water it again. Any old water will do. To follow along with me, I recommend that you watch each step, pause the video, do the step on your own, and then come back.
Okay, so let's pop open our jars and start building these terrariums. The first step is to add your rocks. These are the drainage, as I've said, and so we want them to cover the entire bottom of our terrarium. You're gonna see me smooth them out a little bit, and as long as you can't see the bottom of your jar, that's good. Next, we get to add our soil. This part gets a little bit messy. You'll see I made a big mess, and that's okay, because we can always clean it up at the end. You don't need quite this much soil. It really depends on the size of your plants and the size of your jar. I kind of smoothed it out, but be careful not to compact the soil too much. All right, and now we're gonna make a hole for our plants. Next, we're going to add our plant. Obviously, this is the fun part, but it's also a little bit tricky. I had trouble fitting my hand in that hole, so if you have maybe some tweezers to use that very gently so you don't harm your plant, that might help. You want to make sure he gets tucked in and the roots are covered. And now we get to add in the moss that we collected outside. It'll just sit right on top of the soil and get moisture that it needs. Be really happy in there.
And then next, you're gonna see that I add this piece of bark covered in lichen that I found outside. I think it looks really cool. It kind of looks like a mountain.
And now we get to add in our decorations. So you can see I add in my little pig steak. He's happy there. And then I also add in a couple of rocks on opposite sides. This green one is so pretty. It's one of my favorite rocks I've found. And now we have our finished terrarium. I'm really excited and I really love how this turned out. I think it looks kind of like a mini garden, mini forest, and I'm so excited to see how the plant continues to grow and the terrarium continues to change. And of course, always remember to clean up all your soil.
You want to make sure to keep your terrarium in indirect sunlight and not direct full-blown sunlight for it to stay happy. Someplace that looks like this should be good. There are two issues with your terrarium that you should look out for. It might look too dry or too wet. Your terrarium will look too dry if the soil starts to look really light brown and dusty. When we added it in all moist from the water, it looks this rich, beautiful, dark brown color. But if it starts to look light brown again, go ahead and open it back up and add some more water. The other issue is looking too moist. You will know that your terrarium is looking too moist, it's too wet inside, if you can see lots of condensation on the side of the jar and you can barely see the plants anymore. In this case, you should open the jar back up and let it air out for a few days. As long as you keep an eye out for these two things, you should be totally fine. Don't feel bad if your terrarium doesn't make it. I've made a lot of terrariums before and some of them have died. It's okay, you can always just make another one. They're super fun to make and they look so beautiful. I hope that you all enjoyed making a terrarium today with me. I know that I had a lot of fun. I love terrariums because not only do they showcase how cool plants are sitting on our shelf all day long, but they also remind us of how cool the earth is. Through this terrarium, we get to witness a mini water cycle every day, just like the same water cycle that keeps all of us, plants and animals on earth, happy and healthy. I'd love it if you could share your experience building this terrarium with me in the comments down below. If you love this terrarium plant and you want to see lots of more full-grown plants that would also probably love a terrarium, come visit the conservatories here at MathEye. I hope that you come visit soon. Thank you!